and take a seat, please? Did you hear me at all? You need to be mute. Mute all kills all the boxes. We can have everyone take their seats when we begin our next debate. I get scared when we do that. Thank you for coming back. We are looking forward to this next debate between our candidates for the Republican nomination for Senator, State District 27. With us, we have our incumbent, Senator Jack Murphy, and also Steve Voshall. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining us. If you're just now joining us, our rules will be that each candidate will be given 2 minutes to make their introductory remarks. The next phase will be the debate phase. We'll be asking questions. Each one of you will have 1 minute to respond. We'll start with one candidate, move to your opponent, and then you'll have another minute to respond. The intention is to create a dialogue and give you the opportunity to respond to your opponent's answers. Mr. Joel Knapp is down in the front row. He'll be our timekeeper. He'll be letting you know when we have 1 minute, 15 seconds, and then time's up. And as always, no candidates allowed to send or receive text messages during the debate. We'll begin with Senator Murphy, if you'd like to make your opening remarks.
Yeah, thank you, Ethan. Well, number one, I really appreciate everybody showing up tonight for another series of debates, which I think is probably the last one for the Republican Party before the primary. But thank you, everybody, for coming and taking time away from their family and their kids and their home life. I'm often asked, well, why are you continuing to run, or why do you want to, you know, continue to run for state senator? Well, there's still a lot of things that need to be done down there, and I want to get those accomplished. I want to, one thing I want to get accomplished is to do away with some property taxes. The next thing I want to get accomplished is to do away with our income tax and go to a fair tax or a tax, some kind of consumption tax. I think with the consumption tax, we can probably pick up the extra revenue that we'll need to do away with the property tax, or at least some of the property tax. So, you know, that's two major accomplishments that I want to get done and continue to work on in the Senate. If you just take a minute and look at the endorsements on the table out there, I'm endorsed by the governor, the lieutenant governor, and endorsed by the Georgia Right to Life. The only candidate in this race that is endorsed by the Georgia Right to Life. I've been endorsed about 11 years. I have an A-plus rating with the NRA and have had for years. I have an A-plus rating with the Georgia Chamber of Commerce. So that lets you know a little bit about you know, where I stand and the people that back me and the people that have supported me all the time that I've been in the Senate. I appreciate all the support I've had from the hundreds and hundreds of people that are here in the county and also in the state. But I thank you for being here tonight and look forward to the debate and look forward to continue to serve you in Forsyth County and our great state of Georgia. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Mr. Voshall.
I'm Steve Voshall, and I am running for State Senate seat 27. I want to thank all of you for coming tonight. I know you've all got things that you'd rather be doing than sitting in here listening to politicians talk, but this is a very important debate, and I thank you all for coming tonight. I have lived in Forsyth County for the last 12 years. When I moved up here, I worked up here for a year deciding exactly where I wanted to live. Thoroughly love Forsyth County. My business is located in Forsyth County. I am a small business owner. I have a financial planning and investment business and healthcare business here in town. So I have clients spread all over the metro Atlanta, but primarily here in Forsyth County. So I'm constantly working with people in the county, and I'm aware of all their problems. We've lived here for 12 years. I live in Fellowfields. married to my wife Stacy there, and we have two young teenage daughters that are both in the public schools. We've gone through kindergarten all the way through, right now we're in 10th grade and 7th grade, coach Little League soccer, and have been active in many, many different organizations. I'm a Rotarian, I've been on the United Way Board for 4 years, the Allocation Board for 4 years, Leadership Forsyth graduate. But I'm running to make some change, I want to clean things up, I want to bring honesty, integrity, and ethics back to our state Senate seat. I want to focus primarily on jobs, debt, and taxes. Just because we have a balanced budget doesn't mean we can't be cutting the debt on years where we have a surplus. We need to make Georgia competitive by lowering those taxes, paying off the debt, and make it a magnet for businesses to move here. So we can get this 10% unemployment lower and lead the country in our recovery. Thank you.
Our next round will be our debate questions. Senator Murphy, you will have 1 minute to respond. Senator Murphy, what will you do as a legislator to balance private property rights with environmental regulations?
Well, before we can really balance the private property rights, we've got to do away with things like Agenda 21. The Agenda 21 is taking away our property rights and continues to take it away if it's adopted by counties and cities in the state. We need to do away with things like that, number one. And environmentally, I think that environmentally, we need to make sure that the government, when they're imposing environmental requirements on the private property owners, then they need to make sure that they're the right environmental issues that they are imposing on. That we have things with the environment right now with environmental agencies that are actually costing taxpayers and property owners thousands and thousands of dollars, millions of dollars in lost revenue because they can't dispose of their property because of some environmental issue. And I think those regulations need to be looked at closely, and I think those regulations need to be taken away when we need to.
Mr. Voshall, what will you do as a legislator to balance private property rights with environmental regulations?
Well, as the founder of the Tea Party here in Forsyth County 3 years ago, Agenda 21, which was started by the United Nations a while back, was a way for the governments to take private owners' rights to their property through a number of different names, a number of different reasons, whether it be environmental or roads or anything else. We need to be aware that this is happening. This is not some fantasy fairy tale. This is, when you're a private owner and the government comes after you for something, you're a small fish in a very, very big ocean. And you're going to have a very hard fight. The best way to solve that is not to let it happen. Stop it before it gets going. Once it gets going, it's going to be near impossible to stop. We need to use good common sense. We need to read all the bills thoroughly and make sure that what we're passing under the is what we're actually reading.
Senator Murphy, would you like to add?
Well, again, private property rights under Agenda 21, I've said it before and I'll say it now. Anything that the United Nations is involved in, I don't want us involved in. I would like to see us out of the United Nations, and quite frankly, the United Nations moved off into Dubai somewhere and have us cut down and support them.
Mr. Voshall, would you like to add?
Well, when it's presented to the Georgia legislature, it won't have the United Nations name on it. Going to be coming under a lot of different names. It might have the Republican caucus name on it. We need to identify it for what it is and make sure that we're protecting private landowners.
Mr. Voshall, you'll lead off this next question. Would you support the repeal of the 17th Amendment allowing for direct election of U.S. senators? Why or why not?
I absolutely would. I think that's a huge problem that we've got right now. Our senators realize that they are elected and therefore they don't have as much ownership to the state legislature as they need to have. If they were accountable to the state legislature as it was prior to that, then they're going to have their feet to the fire on issues that affect Georgia a lot more closely than going out to the voter mass in general.
Senator Murphy, would you like to add? Senator Burke?
Yes, I support repealing the 17th Amendment. I think the, when the U.S. Senators have to come to the General Assembly and get their advice, and the General Assembly has to talk to the United States Senators and give them advice, the General Assembly is much more qualified in talking to the U.S. Senators and telling them what issues is important to the state of Georgia and to the counties. And that absolutely needs to be repealed. I support it wholeheartedly.
Mr. Motion, would you like to add to that?
I agree.
Senator Burke, any additional comments?
No, thanks.
Next question, lead off, Senator Burke. What should the state of Georgia do to reduce the cost of health insurance?
Well, there's a number of things that that we have tried to do in the insurance industry to look at reducing the cost of insurance. Unfortunately, right now things are in such limbo because of Obamacare, which I would hope we would get a favorable ruling against Obamacare in the next few hours. We can't really do much until we see where that's going. I helped co-sponsor a resolution, two resolutions, saying that Georgia needs to opt out of the Obamacare that is before the Supreme Court now. And, you know, until that is done, until we get some kind of ruling on that, I don't think we can do a whole lot to reduce the cost of insurance here in the state. But we have, there's been a number of bills that has reduced the cost of the insurance over the last 5-6 years.
Mr. Voshall?
Well, I'm in the healthcare business. I'm an agent, so I deal with consumers all the time, and I have to deal with all the problems. I'm the messenger. So I'm working for the consumer, but I'm having to deal with insurance companies, and I'm having to deal with all the regulations from the government. First and foremost, we need competition. If you're a small business owner under 10 employees, you really do only have about 3 or 4 plan or insurance options with three or four different carriers. That's just not enough competition. Secondly, tort reform needs to be looked at. The medical process, going more computer, investing more in technology, making the claims process more streamlined, and getting the government out of it as much, so there's less regulation and quicker speed of processing.
Senator,
I voted for tort reform. It was 8 years ago when I was in the House. Was one of the leaders on signing on to that bill for tort reform. And that's one way to reduce it. But as an example, we passed a bill last year that said that we could sell insurance across state lines. You know, everybody wanted to be able to sell insurance across state lines. To date, you know what the result of that legislation is? You know how many has been sold across state lines? Zero. So, you know, we have tried to do the things that, you know, to help consumers in the state and make it more competitive, and we want to continue to do that. I work closely with the insurance commissioner, who, Ralph Hudgen, who, by the way, who does endorse me. Thank you.
Mr. Voshall, any additional comments?
Well, I would just say that one thing I can guarantee you in this election is I will have no endorsement from any politicians. I don't think that's necessarily a positive. I am endorsed by the Forsyth County Tea Party, which are citizens who have been following this process religiously for the last 3 years. And I'd much rather be endorsed by citizens who I'm going to be representing in competition.
Next question is for Mr. Voshall. What will you do as part of the General Assembly to protect citizens' rights to bear arms?
I'm a big believer in the Second Amendment. In fact, when I was filling that questionnaire out, I was surprised at how many the way you fill it out, basically the last question is the most aggressive answer to all the questions, and I think I was pretty much every single time the last one. I'm a believer in carrying arms, I'm a believer in hunting, and your right to be able to have guns. The problem is not the guns, the problem is that the criminals have the guns. And, you know, we need to properly educate people on guns and how to protect themselves and how to use one and not to be afraid of the weapon, to The weapon is not the issue, it's the people who are getting it illegally.
Senator Murphy, what will you do as part of the General Assembly to protect citizens' rights and privileges?
Well, I've always been a supporter of the Second Amendment rights. I'm a hunter. I'm endorsed by the NRA and have been for several years, GeorgiaCarry.org, been endorsed by all those organizations. I believe in the Second Amendment. I don't believe that we need to give up our guns under any right. As a matter of fact, I'd like to see that we have and be allowed to carry our weapons and carry our guns without being forced to get a gun permit. Think about the Revolutionary War going back to 1776. Who do you think would have won that war if we had gun permits? Who do you think would have won the Civil War? Well, you know who won the Civil War. I'm thinking of just wishful thinking, I guess. But what would happen in that if we had gun permits in that, in the North, you know, knew where our gun permits were, you know, where would that would never start. So I'd like to see us be able to carry one without permits.
Mr. Voshall.
I'm a strict constitutionalist. That's our right to be able to bear arms and have arms. I think it's pretty common knowledge that one of the main reasons that Japan decided not to invade the West Coast is because they knew that every American had a gun in every household. And that was a big reason why we were able to have the revolution win, because we had the right to bear arms and we weren't a bunch of puppies. Taking lanes and turning them into toll lane based upon how fast they're going.
Senator Murphy. good for this place to have applause, because the more we have applause, the less time we have for questions. So, Senator Murphy, if you could.
Well, you know, I agree with some of that, but, you know, if we pass taxes, I've been told, well, you need to increase the gasoline tax. Okay, so what happens if we'll increase the gasoline tax? What do you think would happen then? I'd be pounded to death about increasing gasoline taxes. So, you know, we've got to look at some way, you know, other than what's been done to get our roads fixed. I mean, sitting here and talking about what we've done with the Northern R and what we've done with some of these things in the past, that's not getting it. We're talking about today. What can we do today to fix our transportation problems? And that's what we got to concentrate on.
Next question for Senator Murphy. What are your top legislative priorities in the next General Assembly?
Well, my top legislative project is to look at, to continue to look at the appraisal process within our state and how properties are being appraised. We're having properties appraised right now that are far, being appraised at far more than what they're worth. That is just driving homeowners right out of their homes. I get calls every week on that. Another thing we need to look at is the reduction of property taxes. And the thing that we need to keep looking at, just like we did this last session, is where we give a tax decrease to seniors, is to continue to look at what we can do to decrease the taxes and go to a consumption tax in this state. And like, go to something that where we can get our arms around it and reduce the taxes, not only here, but federally.
Mr. Voshall, what are your top legislative priorities in the next General Assembly?
Jobs, debt, and taxes. And when we get done with that, jobs again.
Senator Murphy, would you like to?
Well, jobs, of course, when we give tax breaks to different companies like Caterpillar, bringing 1,400 jobs into this state, that's the kind of things that we need to continue to do, is look at giving to get jobs into the state. We're going to have to give some companies to breaks. Breaks on some of their taxes to get them here, and I think that's going to create the jobs in the state and in the county. We've got to do the same thing in the county. The county has got to get away from being a bedroom community for Fulton County and Atlanta. We've got to increase our taxes by our income on our taxes by having businesses move into the county, good, reliable businesses.
Mr. Rush, would you like to add anything?
Once we've cleaned up the issue of spending and streamlining the DOT, I would prefer to see it done on the gas tax. The system's there. People watch. What's the one thing that everyone watches more than anything else? Gas prices. It'll get people involved on the issue, get people watching the issue, and people that are driving through this state using the roads will be paying for those roads.
Senator Murphy, what do you think is the best way to fund and construct state transportation projects?
Well, one of the ways is gas tax, but it's far more complicated for me to sit here and try to explain that in 30 seconds to increase the gas tax. That's one way to fund. But I still think we need to look, and we've got to be able to get some private money in here. We do not have the tax revenue in this state to fund projects. So the only way that I think we can go is look at public-private partnerships to help build our roads and help get our traffic.
Discussions like that.
So then we're going to be paying profits to a profit enterprise on our roads. That doesn't make any sense. And I think the real reason we don't want to add it to the gas tax is because the elected officials know that we're all watching the gas tax, and they don't want to take the heat for that. You know, if we need the roads, then we need to pay for them. We need to pay for them through the gas tax.
Well, I would be glad to look at a survey that and see what people say about increasing their gas tax And if my constituents want me to increase it, then I would absolutely vote for it. But I'd like to see a survey first to see that they want me to increase their taxes.
This next question we let off on Mr. Murphy. Do you consider yourself to be pro-life or pro-choice? Do you believe there are any situations where abortion is justified?
Like I said at the beginning of my introduction statement there, that I am endorsed by the Georgia Right to Life and have been endorsed by the Georgia Right to Life for 11 years. The only candidate in this race that is endorsed by them. I don't believe abortion should be legal under any circumstances except to save the life of the mother in certain circumstances.
Mr. Buck, do you need to repeat the question?
No, I don't. I am a lifetime Catholic, and I am pro-life. I am probably the only candidate that has been up here who's had to go through this. We were told to abort our second pregnancy and had to live through, you know, probably 11 weeks of hell, and had to deal with that and pray with that every single night. I can't begin to tell you the stress and the agony that goes into that decision. We opted to have our second child. Our second child was perfectly normal. So I'm opposed to using tax dollars to fund any kind of abortion, and I'm opposed to, I'm definitely pro.
My sympathies goes out to Wilson and his wife for having to go through that ordeal, because I can't begin to tell you this is such an important issue, and there's so much emotion on it that that it's just hard to even comprehend unless you have went through
it. Mr. Buck, any issue? Senator Murphy? I'm sorry, this is Mr. Buck's question. Mr. Buck, do you believe that there should be legislation capping the value of gifts from lobbyists to state legislators?
I definitely support lobbying, caps on lobbying gifts. That is, it's hard to believe we don't have gifts. And the lobbyists do have a reason for being down there. They do a lot of educating on a lot of the bills. They do have, we all are every one of our needs down there is represented by some kind of lobby, whether we want to acknowledge that or not. So there are good lobbyists down there, but the idea of flying to France for 14 days on a family trip and going on a golf outing and all this other stuff, I mean, there's absolutely no need for that. And to say that just because we have transparency on that makes it okay, doesn't make it okay. There definitely needs to be limits on those.
Senator Murphy?
I support limits on lobbyist gifts to politicians. I'm not sure, you know, what the cap should be. I've told that it's supposed to be $100 in cap. I wrote him the other day. My response said, absolutely, I support the county cap on lobbyist gifts. I said, and they told me what the legislation was going to be. And I said, well, in the 10 years I've been down there, legislation has a way of changing by the time it gets to you. So I prefer to see the legislation, and I think my constituents would prefer me read the legislation before I sign off on anything and see what it says. But again, I do support limits on lobbyist gifts.
Mr. Voshall? Senator Murphy, any additional?
No, thanks.
Senator Murphy, what will you do to improve your legislative district's water supply?
Well, I made two trips to Washington trying to get them to raise the lake level by 2 feet, which would create the equivalent of Lake Seminole. I have talked with them. I have pleaded with them. I have begged them to do that. So far, they are not listening. That's one thing we need to do. That is the quickest thing we can do and the most economical thing we can do. We need to look at all options. We need to look at building the reservoirs, which would take about 10 years even if we started today with a permit. We need to look at some kind of withdrawal from the Tennessee River and working out something with the Tennesseans. Let us withdraw that water from which wouldn't make any difference to them, but we need to look at that. And maybe we can have a trade-off with that. Maybe we can, give them permission to build a fast train up to Chattanooga or something and trade off with the water. But we need to look at that. We need to look at all options.
Mr. Voshall, what would you do to improve your legislative district's water supply?
You know, it's amazing. The metro Atlanta area is the biggest metro Atlanta, biggest metro city in the country that doesn't have a major underground aquifer. Well, what we have is above ground. And we also don't have a very big river that runs through Atlanta. I mean, the Chattahoochee starts as a tiny little creek in North Georgia. And yet, we are constantly being held at a competitive disadvantage by Florida and Alabama playing politics, fighting us for the water. So obviously raising the lake 2 feet. And I have a little house on the lake. I'm up there all the time. I'm always having to bring a dog in, push it out. I mean, I see it happen more closely than maybe a lot of people. And it's quite frustrating. Dealing with the core is even more frustrating. So working that out, but I also think we have a real legal right to the water in the Tennessee River. And for some reason, we haven't pushed it. And I would like to see it go to court and start that process, because that process might take 8 years. And we need to get that process started.
Mr. Senator, perfect.
Well, living on the lake for 29 years, I can tell you what it is to deal with the Corps of Engineers, because I've been dealing with them for 29 years. I've watched the lake go up to 1075. I've watched it to 1073. It's been 1073 over 300 times. They know exactly what has to be done to raise that lake by 2 feet. But when you talk to them, they say, oh, we got to do all these studies. I cornered them one day and said, look, don't you have those studies? It's been at 1073. And they finally said, well, yeah, we do have this. I said, well, why do you want to spend all this money to do this and get more studies done? So I have battled with the Corps of Engineers for 29 years. And one of these days, we just won something. We just won a court battle to where it was just asinine to think that our drinking water from Lake Lanier water wasn't for drinking. That was just crazy. So I'm glad to see us win that after spending probably millions of dollars defending.
Discussion? Thank you.
Well, besides the lake issue, we have a water contract issue here locally. City, county, state, EPD permits to clean the water that we need to be able to clean. And one of the biggest things is going to be able to get the permit so that our new water plant can clean the water that we have. We get the raw water. Right now we're paying the city clean water, and we can clean ourselves if we had the permit. And that's the state agency.
Mr. Virtual, next question for you would be, should the state assist in funding a new stadium for the Atlanta Falcons?
No. Absolutely not.
Senator Murphy?
No way should we fund a new stadium, not in this economic time or any time. Now, if Mr. Blank wants to pay for that stadium, he feel free to do so, but not the state.
Come on, guys, I need to drag this out a little longer. Steve, do you have anything additional? Okay. Senator Murphy. What will you do to prevent illegal immigration in Georgia?
Well, as chairman of the Senate Immigration Reform Committee, we had three meetings on that before last. And as a result of that meeting, we came up with Senate Bill 40, which was our immigration reform bill. And that bill was combined with House Bill 87, Matt Ramsey's bill, which is now the bill that was passed and the law we're under. As a state, we're doing everything we can to control immigration, illegal immigration in the state. But it's going to be up to the federal government ultimately what they do, and they haven't done anything. The federal government, and I'm talking about Republicans and Democrats, has not done anything about illegal immigration for years. And it's time we do something about it. We can issue some kind of visas, work visas, and charge these illegal immigrants for the work visas and turn it into a revenue generating, which will pay for itself, and let them work here for 3 years and also document them. I mean, there's things they can do, and they can do it today, but they're not doing it.
Mr. Voshall, what will you do as a member of the General Assembly to to prevent illegal immigration?
Well, first, you know, I don't have a problem charging a fee for a work visa, but I don't want to put the Georgia legislature and the Georgia state into the business of being coyotes. I don't want this to be a profitable thing where we're charging immigrants, illegal aliens, $3,000, $4,000 for this fee that Senator Murphy pointed out last time in the last debate for them to come and work here. All of a sudden, now we are legalized coyotes, and I disagree with that. I mean, many of our great-grandparents came through Ellis Island. I know mine did. We have a serious immigration problem that has to be fixed at the federal level. We have a major security issue, letting people come in on the borders that we, national security that we need to solve. And we also have to recognize that a lot of our major businesses rely on this labor force. It's got to be looked at much more closely and not dealt with a broad brush, because a broad brush isn't going to work in this situation.
Senator, Mr. Voshall's got a point. The federal government has to do its part. What can you as state legislators do?
Well, I think that, you know, passing the E-Verify part of the deal to see who is illegal and who is not legal here, I disagree with Mr. Voshall's assessment of coyotes. I feel like as far as illegal immigration goes, we've kind of been the white part and meat of the chicken, and they've been taking advantage of over $40 billion is spent in this country educating illegal immigrants, educating them K through 12. We spent over $40 billion in that. Now, I don't mind charging $3,000 for a work permit. I mean, they're costing us $40 billion. So I don't mind that at all. So I think there can be a solution, and I think our bill with the E-Verify has been a good start on that.
Mr. Voshall?
I think the bill on the E-Verify was a start. My point is, when you get government involved in something like that, where it's the money-making revenue for them, it's going to get out of control, and it's going to be corrupted for the wrong means. We need to have a streamlined work visa. If they have a job here, there needs to be a streamlined work visa. I'd also like to see urgent care facilities next to the hospitals that have the greatest emergency care usage in these areas where there are people using the emergency room. There's no reason to go to the emergency room and go, to go against their nonprofit and basically tax dollars pay for it. When they can go, they have cash. They can go to an urgent care and pay for that. And they do pay sales tax and other taxes. So I just think we need to look at this more carefully and get a good handle on it.
No, that's it. Mr. Voshall. The Georgia Constitution prohibits same-sex marriage, so that's off the table. As a legislator, will you support a law recognizing same-sex civil unions?
No. No, I don't believe that marriage or a union is anything other than a male female. So I would not support it.
Senator Murphy, same question?
No, absolutely not. I mean, anybody that has reached the Bible any time or as a Christian, I don't know how you can support anything other than a marriage between a man and a woman. I mean, it'd be hard for us to be here if it wasn't between a man and a woman. So, no, I don't.
Mr. Voshall?
I can't disagree with that.
Senator, same question, but not just marriage, same-sex civil unions. Would you support that?
No.
The state's education system?
Well, I wish that the state could model their education system on Forsyth counties. We have one of the best education systems in the entire state, if not the best. My daughter's a teacher who is actually in the audience here and has been teaching up here for quite a while. And I run things by her often, and we get into some conversations about what's going on. One thing we can do is we can support vouchers. I believe in vouchers, I believe that we should, I believe in charter schools. I believe that competition is how we increase our educational system. I believe it's the right of every parent to go out and seek the best education for their children that they can find. This environment that we're in today, in this world, and in this state, and in this county, your children deserve the best education that you can get to keep up in this current environment.
Well, I'm a big believer in vouchers and charter schools. I think their parents need to have a choice. You cannot, my mom is I grew up in a household with a main breadwinner was a teacher. So that's, he was saying, grow up rich. And I dealt with my mom having to go get recertified and everything. And, you know, it's, I've got a unique perspective on that. But you can't throw money at education. You need parental involvement, and you need to get the parents involved. Atlanta schools are a good you know, example of that. I mean, they get a lot more per student, but their test score is terrible. The other thing that I'm very worried about is what's happening at our college and university level for cost is getting, it's cost prohibitive. Kids are coming out of school $100,000 in debt. So I'd like to see the Regency system get zero-based budget, be one of the agencies that would have to go through zero-based budget early and get that under control and start seeing some caps on the spending.
I agree that the Regency system needs to go through the zero-based budget, no matter, like everybody else does. Currently, we spend 52% of our budget in the state. 52% of our total budget is spent on education. That's K through 12 in the regions. So we're spending a lot of money on helping to educate our children. And I think that's up from 47% previously. So we have increased that by 5%. I can't think of anything else we can do except to just continue like we're doing, try to get the county, get the state operating like the county, get vouchers, get charter schools, get competition in our school system.
Well, if you keep on continuing like you're doing right now, you're going to keep on getting the same results. I think, first of all, we've got to change some things up, and we need to, the vouchers is a great way of doing that. But I think you've got to start holding these departments that are just out of control in spending. No one really knows how much these departments are spending or where it's going or what it's going for. Zero-based budgeting is only going to be a few departments per year, but I think the school, the Regency system needs to be top of that list.
Senator?
Well, I agree. I mean, we're just repeating, you know, what we said. We need to have zero-based budgeting in the regions, and that will help a whole lot to drive it. But I disagree. You can look at the budget, and I'd be glad to furnish the budget. It's about 2 inches thick. I'd be glad to furnish it, let you go through it, and see where the line items are on this spending.
Very good, Jim. Thank you. The next round, we finished our question round. At this point, you have a minute and a half to make the closing remarks. We'll start with Mr. Voshall.
Well, first, let me thank everyone for coming tonight. I'd like to thank Ethan and the Forsyth County GOP for putting this on. I don't think I mentioned earlier, too, that I am a GOP member here in the county. I'm a delegate. I was a precinct chair. I was instrumental to get the Ethics and Accountability Committee started inside the county GOP, and I chaired that this past year. I think transparency and ethics is something that we need to work on down in the state. Certainly jobs, debt is going to help. Debt reduction makes our county, makes our state more competitive with the surrounding states. The more competitive we are, the more businesses are going to move here. And then we got to lower taxes. We need to do away with the state income tax, and that's not going to happen overnight, but we need to start working towards that. Our surrounding states around us don't have it, and we've got to get more competitive. Thank you for coming tonight.
Senator Murphy.
Well, again, I want to thank everybody for coming and taking up their time tonight to come listen to the debate. This is a great part of America when you can have debates like I've been a Republican ever since I was in the Air Force, which was quite a few years ago. I was a Republican when you couldn't afford a hamburger. So I couldn't afford a hamburger. And it's been a great privilege for me to serve the state of Georgia and Forsyth County for all these years. And I just want to say in closing that this election is important to me. But I want to say that the coming election in November is the most important election we'll have, or I'll have, I know, in my lifetime. So my election's important, but it doesn't hold a candle to the election that's coming up in November, where we have got to change Washington and change the president of Washington and elect a Republican. No matter how you feel about it or something, again, we have to elect a Republican. But thank you for being here, and God bless you and your family.
Thank you all for coming. If you know anyone who is not registered to vote in the upcoming primary, Monday is the deadline. You can go on the Secretary of State's site and get the voter registration information. It either has to be delivered to the county election registrar, or it has to be placed in the mail postmark by July the 2nd. So please get folks involved. We want as many people participate in this election as possible. We look forward to working with you in the fall with the Republican Party as we prepare for the general election. We appreciate all that you do, and we look forward to seeing you at all your July meeting on the 21st. Thank you. Steve, good job. Appreciate it. Just thank you.
Hey man, how are you? Good job, man. That's really a good job.
The lady that videotaped the the debate is out here videotaping your car.
Oh, cool. Hi.
Hi.
How are you this evening?
Doing very well. Thank Good. You for asking. So, are you from Forsyth County?
I'm from Roswell. My name is Nydia Tisdale.
And you're videotaping everything. And why? Just out of curiosity.
I put it on YouTube so that people who couldn't come to tonight's debate can watch it online.
That's good.
And hear what the candidates have to say.
That's great.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
And it'll be on the website called aboutforsyth.com.
I'm just saying, okay. Brainwashed.
That's great. Thank you.
It's going to be medicine for illegals.
Yeah.
They can go to hospitals. You know Peach State?